ASD, and I don't know really where I'm going yet, but we're just checking out the floor. This is like the international sourcing area, so China, Pakistan, India, it's kind of cool. There's I see all sorts of things. There's like cool backpacks over there. Pretty awesome. Checking out the jewelry section right now. It's pretty cool. I don't even know where to start here. Hi, Isaac.
Hello.
Lots of deals going on. I'm kind of interested in jewelry. I just got approved. Really looking for somewhere to start. I can't do fine jewelry, so I think my thinking is to look for things that are easy to keyword, things that are really unique or special or interesting. Not necessarily the most beautiful things, but definitely things that have keywords, maybe religious. I'm looking there, maybe religious items, maybe things about particular interests, and there's so much to look for. Oh, I love these Hawaiian bracelets. These are pretty awesome. I think really I got approved in jewelry fairly recently, so I'm thinking of things that are good to keyword, things that are unique or different or special. Not necessarily the most beautiful things, but definitely things that people would look for. So I'm thinking like niches, like maybe religious things or new age, maybe pets or cyber things. Like something that's different, people would look at. These are really gorgeous. I love these. Really unique bracelets. Yeah, there's a lot of deals going on. It's actually a really chill atmosphere. People just walking the floor, seeing what's there, seeing what's what. So many things to look at. It's pretty useful, actually, as prices up. I love these. These are so different. This place is huge. You could go on for another niche I've been thinking about moving into. It's more like body jewelry, body piercing. These are pretty cool. I like these Batman ones there. But I think it's kind of an untapped niche. It's something that people specifically look for if they want certain piercings. I guess I'm just looking for things that catch my eye. I love, there's like the bags of my people up there, and I love that US one.
I wonder if you can sell a fashion accessory and you get a cool hat and a bag.
You want to do a cool hat and a bag? That's pretty cool.
I can see that.
You'd have to be mixing your apparel and your bags. These are earplugs. It's pretty interesting.
A growing trend in our youth culture is to.
is this your documentary?
It really is.
I'm gonna get my ears stretched just so I can wear these rose gold earplugs. These are pretty different, though. You don't see much like this. So they have the price list. They've got 50% off some of this stuff. Pretty cool, we got our first catalog. First card, easy. Really friendly people, everyone's really chill. I don't know, I heard so many warnings and so many do's and don'ts, and everyone's really happy. They're all here to sell their stuff and talk about it. People are really into what they're doing, what they're selling. Just all I see here is a lot of opportunities. A lot of opportunities.
Yeah, so we have, this is
a lot of our stuff. Do you mind me taking a picture? Oh, no, my daughter's a big Owl fan as well. She would love those. Yeah, this is such a cool.
This has a lot of styles in it.
Okay.
We have all of our styles online. Obviously, you can check us out.
Sure.
I'll give you a couple of our cards.
That's great. This is really beautiful jewelry. I love it. So we're in the China sourcing area right now. A little bit different. In the jewelry, there are a lot of personal buyers, a lot of people buying for themselves. In here, they're only letting people in who are wholesale buying. So, Isaac's checking out the aquaponics, the hydroponics. He's really into that. But there's just like everything you can think of here. I mean, thinking about treasure hunting, like this is where there's treasure.
It's a self kill system. It's just feed of fish.
And what I'm noticing here is that everyone is so enthusiastic about what they sell. Like they're really happy to share their knowledge.
You don't have to water
here. I don't know, I had the fear about coming here and checking everything out. And actually I'm finding everyone so positive, so helpful. Collecting catalogues very rapidly though, price lists. But getting so many ideas. This is like clown balloon place right here. It's literally a world out there to source from. There's a guy over here doing a sourcing seminar about how to source from overseas. But look at it, China, India, Pakistan, Taiwan, so many places, so many opportunities. Some cool bags over here, sports products, decorations, just every niche you can think of. I think Isaac's busy trying to work out a hydroponics deal. Let's go see if he's handling that. Yeah, he's still busy negotiating over here. You know, I don't think he is negotiating. I think he just likes playing with the hydroponics. Really cool niche, though.
Yeah.
You put it in the home, it can look like an eyesore for a lot of homes.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing I would...
The thing that's interesting, I think there's a lot of misconceptions about sourcing from China. This guy's actually explaining to Isaac... Actually, this is from Taiwan. This guy's explaining to Isaac about how sustainable and organic the products are that they're looking at. He's talking about the paper being sustainable, the wood being sustainable. I mean, there is attention to quality here. It's really cool to see the products that are actually selling in use. So I'm in beauty and sunglasses and accessories. I'm just digging those. There's like cannabis sunglasses over there. It's pretty fun. It's kind of a theme at the moment, the leaves everywhere. We just saw some cool oversized watches. You know, I think part of the trick is just looking for things that are really different, that really stand out, that you can't find in most places.
Like that awesome dress up there?
That's my next dress right up there. That's pretty awesome.
Is that a peacock?
You see it, yeah. It's pretty cool. Oh, wait for it, Isaac.
Nice.
You approve?
I approve.
Wow. There's a market for everything. Footwear up here. Gonna go check out the shoes. So I'm very much looking as an Amazon seller, just in the categories that I'm approved in. Not yet selling clothes, but I should really get approved in clothes very soon. But I'm doing shoes, sunglasses, jewelry. I'm really looking to expand into those categories, so this is a really cool opportunity. I love boots. Boots are one of the first things I sold when I sold on eBay, especially rain boots. And I love the heels as well. I love like the strip of shoes and the heels. And hey, these are pretty awesome. Kind of remind me of the barefoot shoes, but really like so many unique products. Oh, in fact, better than barefoot. This is pretty cool, I want to check in on this. Oh my gosh, I just saw the cat bag over there, the game over bag. And I woke up like this, that's so cool. I love the bag. So the thing with selling online, it's not enough just to have things that are pretty, because it's not like people are going to walk in off the streets and browse your things. That might work for like Facebook marketing when you're actually putting something up in people's face and saying, hey, look at this. But for Amazon, people don't tend to be browsing by looks. So your number one priority is really getting the keywords, getting something that's really individual that people are actually search for. And then your second priority is making it look good so that people actually want to buy it. But you've got to make it findable before you can sell it. So that's where sort of like bags like this come in, because you can sell it as shopping and shopaholic and all those kind of cool words. Love to shop. And then it becomes a lot easier to sell than just pink bag or beige bag. I love these over here, aren't they gorgeous? They're like Western bags. And you've got the turquoise, it's a big thing at the moment. People are really big into turquoise, Western. I love these ones over here.
Country cowboy.
These are gorgeous, I love these. Really good deals as well. Bundlers, I have found your paradise. This is like the dollar store on steroids. Oh my gosh, so many cool things. Hi. I love the straws. Are those straws?
Yeah, paper straws, two quarter straws.
That's so awesome. 55 cents per bag on the straws and party bags. Wow. Okay, bundlers, check it out again. Balloons with numbers, letters. I'm thinking you could spell out words with these. 2015, I'm thinking there's other things you can do here. Happy birthday, graduation. I don't know, balloons are talking to me today. Amazing, this is like literally dollar store stuff, but wholesale. I sold a few of those products last year. I guess this is really the way to do seasonal products. Just order wholesale in advance. No more running around Walmart. There's the Valentine's. Yeah, you can really get ahead of the game with products here. Oh, these are cool. Ice cream decorations, lollipops. It's like a winter wonderland.
I have a look at another.
Oh, okay.
I have time.
Yeah.
So my next step, I think, is getting ungated in clothes. I'm in jewelry, shoes, handbags at the moment, but really want to move into clothes. One big reason, not a lot of competition. And check it out. I love these niche things. These are the kind of things people look for on Amazon. If you're looking, and this is where like people who have experience on eBay can bring those skills, because you're looking at keywords, you're looking at niches, you're looking at things that have something very particular about them. Check out the Homeland Security ones. I love that one with the skeletons over there. And like guns, freedom. These are all things that people are gonna be looking up. Second Amendment. And this is somewhere else. So a lot of people have seen like my Rising International hoodie that I wear in a lot of videos and screencasts and things. I found my stores. These are so cool. So much scope with these. These are just cool, cool products. Love them. What do we think about the jumpsuits? Pretty out there. But I think the trick is definitely, the first thing you want to be is findable. So you have to be specific so that you're findable. So that's where the keywords, the niches, the target audience, the demographics, the market comes in. The second thing is you want to look good. So pretty much you can cover it here. You don't have to have high-end brands. You don't need to be selling like the Tommy Hilfiger. You just have to have something that's findable and looks good. clothes is the next step. Dress. I feel that Stevie would wear this dress. I love these clothes here, the international clothes, the really bright, colourful things. I love the gypsy, hippie, boho kind of looks. And again, specific dress over there. And jewellery. I think one of the big keys with jewellery, and jewellery is definitely something I'm looking at doing, and I said this yesterday when we were walking around the jewellery section, is definitely products that have something specific about them and something that's unique. There's not going to be a lot of competition for these. You can't scan them and then find them on Amazon. You've got to create the listing and set it up for yourself. Check it out, marine products, huge, huge niche. Anything military. Basically, if you can imagine someone wanting it, someone really looking for these particular things, you can find them. Make sure everything's legit. If you're gonna go with big brands, it's gotta be legit. There's Harley Davidson, but really cool stuff.
No, they actually have.
What's really interesting here is the different attitudes towards Amazon sellers. Like, there's one guy here, and he was talking about how he's basically a drop shipper. You can order the products from him, and he'll just send them to Amazon straight for you, or he'll drop ship them to your customers, and you don't have to do much with it at all. And he's totally all about Amazon. And then you go to like two booths along, and there was a lovely lady who actually gave me this really awesome hair tie. And she was really interested in what we do. But she actually asked outright, are you guys Amazon sellers? Do you sell on Amazon? And she said she doesn't like selling to Amazon sellers. She's worried that they'll crash the price on her product. And that was what she actually said. She's like, well, we have the MAP price, the minimum advertised price, and we don't want any Amazon sellers because they usually sell below that price and it's really hard to please. So it's kind of interesting. What I found, everyone's pretty friendly. Everyone's interested in what you do. Be honest with people, talk to people. But yeah, all the vendors have a different approach, and that's cool. But be honest with them, because there are so many opportunities here. A lot of people love Amazon sellers, some not so much, but better to like strike a deal with someone that you can talk to on a sensible, honest basis.
Now through the closeout aisles, and you can see there's just mass amount of stuff. if that was to sum up our entire experience here, it would just be massive amount of stuff. But it's been really interesting. And hey, look, all the frozen stuff.
I can't start off slow.
What about these?
These were all over Walmart in the Christmas clearance.
Oh, really?
Big time.
How are the rankings on them online?
The painting sets?
Yes.
They do well.
And also, it's okay to send these in?
Yep, the painting sets are okay. These ones?
Mm-hmm.
Don't send these in. They've got aerosols.
Oh, okay.
But I've done well with these ones before.
Okay. Now, can you merchant fulfill these?
Yeah.
Okay, just don't send them in
FBA. Yeah, but they're hazmat, so you gotta be careful.
I see. What are these up here? Is that keychains or something?
Sanitizer. Sanitizer also hazmat. It's alcohol based.
Oh. That's too bad. I think this would be great for parents buying it for their kids.
Bundleable as well.
OCD parents. I wouldn't know any.
OCD parents?
I wouldn't know. Someone who's obsessed with sanitizing.
I see bundleable products. Back to school tissues. You know tissues are always on back to school lists. Teachers, they always want wet wipes and tissues. Again, wet wipes, hazmat. We're gonna go do lunch.
Okay, let's go. Hey, it's one of these signs.